The third technique I'm going to explain here is something I've seen a lot of users do when they prototype in Axure, so I'm going to take you through it step by step as well. We are going to have one dynamic panel that includes the menu in separate states, one state per submenu. The difference this time is that the buttons that should make the menu appear will also be inside the dynamic panel. That means we'll need an additional state, which will be empty, where we'll see the buttons, but no menu will be displayed below. So let's create the states. They'll all roughly look like this, with the header menu at the top, and then a submenu below. I've seen this technique used a lot because it allows to make the active menu item visible more easily. For example, now we're going to underline the visit button. By default, I don't want to see any submenu, so I'll make the empty state the first one in the list, so it's visible by default. And then inside, I want to have only the top menu with the buttons. That will allow me to display the submenus later on. Now I'm going to create all of the different states of the panel and put every submenu in the appropriate state. So I'm just selecting the submenu I want to add, cut it using Ctrl X, and then create a new state, edit it, and then paste the content inside. And I'm repeating this for every submenu. Notice that I'm not adding the top buttons every time, because I want to add interactions on them. So it's better to add the interactions once, and then copy-paste the whole block into the different states. Now that my dynamic panel has all the states I'll ever need, I'm going back to the empty version and add interactions on the different buttons. On click on one of the buttons, I want to set the state of the panel to the state that contains the submenu for that button. Using this technique, the dynamic panel is always visible, it just changes from one state to another, so you don't need to show the dynamic panel or to check the Show if Hidden box. Now I just have to add the same interaction to all of the buttons and make the interaction point to the right panel state. Now that I have all the interactions, I can just select all of these buttons and copy-paste them into the different states, so I don't have to code the interactions again every time. You can open all the states of a dynamic panel at once using this button. Then all of the states open in separate tabs. I use this to keep track of which states I've finished editing by closing them and which I still need to do more work on. All that's left now is pasting the main buttons into each state and then moving the submenu so that it's at the right position. I had already placed the buttons without the interactions in the Visit tab. Rather than adding the interactions to it, I'm just going to delete it and paste the version with the interactions already on it. Now I'll preview the result, but first I need to place the menu in the right position, because right now it's to the right of the rest of my page. As you can see, whenever I click on one of the buttons, it displays the correct submenu. However, right now I'm not able to hide the menu again, so I'll need to add a new interaction for this. So we're going to edit all of the states one more time. In the empty state, whenever I click on a button, I should show a menu, so that's fine. But when I'm in a state where a menu is open, whenever I click on the same button that should open that menu, it should close it instead, so here I need to make a change. I'll also underline the active menu using the Ctrl U shortcut. Now I have to repeat the same steps on all of the states. And now let's preview the new result. I can easily open and close every menu by clicking on the button, and I can switch seamlessly from one to the other, and the active menu is underlined.